Do you think of your career as a game? Maybe you should. My name's Michelle Holland. I'm the kick-ass performance coach, and I'm going to talk to you all about how your career, it's just a game. So, I know that you've heard of the politics in the office, the politics at work. You've heard all about that, right? It's just a game. And it really is. And the thing is, you have to play the game. Your career is made up of this game. It's just a game. I know that sounds terrible because you're really passionate about your work and you're really passionate about the things you do. And don't stop, okay? Make sure you stay passionate about everything you do. That's essential. That's one of the essential things for playing this game. The career game is all about points. And there's a balance of points. Now, the two kind of points that you have to play, and you have to play off against each other and get the right balance, is credibility points versus doubt points. Now, you've probably heard about the emotional bank account. And if you haven't, then you'll hear all about it in my programs. It's when you put something into somebody's emotional bank account so that you can kind of draw on it later. And we'll tell you all the ratios later on. Your career game is basically the same. You have to put in heaps of credibility points to make sure that if there's any doubt points being drawn, that they don't overweigh the credibility points. All right, so it's a real balancing act here. You want, obviously, way more credibility points than you do doubt points. You have to play the game. There's no choice. If you want to have a successful career, you have to play the career game. And I can teach you all about the career game. That's not a problem. My next blog, I'm going to talk to you about how you get credibility points. And then the last blog in this series, I'm going to tell you all about how you accumulate doubt points and how to stop doing that. This one is about convincing you that you need to play the game. I know that you don't want to. I've heard that many people say to me, I'm not going to play those politics games. I'm not going to do it. I'm going to go do my own thing. I've got too much integrity. I've got too much self-confidence. I've got too much of whatever it is. The thing is, if you're not going to play this game, then you're not going to win. And you want to win because you want to be successful. You want to beat out the competition. You want to be next in line for that promotion. You want to be the person that you know, next level leader starts looking at and goes, that's the person. That's the one with the potential. You'll get looked at as the one with the potential because you're playing the game. And it's no different for people out in the other world. We're going to talk about how you build that credibility and how you build the credibility points and how they come in. And here's the thing. If you're managing a career and you're right at the beginning of it, you got heaps of time and heaps of potential for heaps of credibility points. It's not too late though. If you feel like you've got a bit of a bucket load of doubt points maybe, and we'll talk about them, it's not too late to build the credibility points. There's also no difference if you're a young up-and-coming entrepreneur. You still have to build those credibility points, hey. So whether you're managing and building a career as a young professional and aspiring leader, or you've decided that starting your own business is the way you want to head in your career, you still need a really healthy balance of credibility points versus doubt points. Play the game or you won't win. That's that's the reality. All right, so in our next blog, I'm going to teach you all about how to get lots and lots and lots of credibility points for your career or your business. My name is Michelle Holland. Stay inspiring.